What's up, guys? Jay Rocky from the Web3 Experience Podcast here. Today, I'm going to be walking you through how to complete the Optimism Quest for Pika, claim your free NFT, and then check to see what it's worth on Quix. If you want to follow along, I included a link to this quest as well as the Quix NFT marketplace in the video description below. So Pika is a decentralized trading platform currently offering up to 100x leverage on their perpetual products, which basically means you can trade crypto with up to 100x leverage. If you're familiar with futures and traditional finance system, perpetual futures function the same way except for one key difference. And that is that traditional futures have an expiration date and perpetual futures do not. This means that you can keep your leverage position open as long as you want because there is no end date for the contract that you're trading. Effectively, your position is open perpetually until you close it. Now, if this all sounds familiar, it's probably because you watched the Optimism Quest tutorial for Quenta or Perpetual Protocol. For everyone who hasn't checked those out, I included a link to those tutorials above, so check them out and grab your free NFTs. Anyway, let's get to the Pika quest. So it looks like we're going to have to do two things. Number one, open a margin trade with greater than or equal to 30 USDC on Pika. And then the second one that seems to be tripping everybody up because of the wording is deposit greater than or equal to 30 USDC liquidity into a liquidity pool on Pika and keep it locked for at least 3 days. And I'll explain this one a little bit further and what to do whenever we get there. But let's start with the margin trade. We'll head over to Pika. We'll click start trading. Now we'll make sure we're in the trade tab. We'll click on ETH USD. We'll make sure we're on market order. And then we're going to open up a long trade on ETH USD. And so for that, we're going to need to open up at least a $30 position. So under here in margin where it says USDC, we're going to type 35. And then we're going to go down here to this slider and bump the leverage up just a little bit to 2. Now, effectively, what that's going to do is take 35 USDC from our wallet and open up us a position in ETH worth 70 USDC, which just happens to be right now 0.0440 ETH. Now, it doesn't matter what sort of leverage you use or what level of leverage you use, as the only thing that matters is this is over $30. So we're going to click approve. We're going to sign the transaction. And it looks like we're approved. Now you may be confused because the approve button is still here, but in Web3, the rule of thumb is when in doubt, just refresh the page. So we'll refresh the page. And of course, now it caught it with the submit button, but we have to re-enter our $35, 2x leverage, click enable market order, accept terms and enable orders, sign the transaction. Okay, our transaction went through and now you'll see this green submit button. We'll click that. And before we click confirm, I want to take you through some of what this means. So effectively, we used 35 USDC to open up a 2x position on ETH, which would be worth $70, 2 times 35 at the market price of $15.92. Very important, estimated liquidation price. This means that Ethereum cannot fall below $9.5677 or else your $35 in margin will get liquidated. We'll click confirm. We'll sign the transaction. Then it looks like our transaction went through. We know this because you can go down here to positions and you'll see your open position here and your liquidation price. So since we already met the criteria for the quest, and I don't feel like leverage trading ETH at the moment, I'm actually going to go ahead and close out this position. You'll click the close position button. You'll go down to current size here. You'll click 70 or whatever your current size is. This will give you the max amount to close out your entire position. You'll click close position. You'll sign the transaction. And then this nice box will pop up with your profit and loss. It looks like we made 0.3% on our trade. So we'll exit out of this. And we can tell that our position is closed because we can see down in positions, there's nothing here. And then up here, you'll also see your wallet balance. So we have another $35 in our wallet plus that 4 cents in profit. Okay, now let's go into the second part of the quest, which could be a little bit confusing because of the language that they use in here versus what you actually do in the protocol. So deposit greater than or equal to 30 USDC liquidity into a liquidity pool on Pika and keep it locked for at least 3 days. Now, what they mean by this is you're actually going to click over here into the vault tab and you're providing USDC liquidity into their vault. Now, instead of their add liquidity button, they actually have a stake button down here. So we'll click stake. We'll type in 35 USDC. We'll click approve. We'll sign the transaction. Then you'll see this blue stake button pop up. We'll click that. We'll sign the transaction. And you can see that we added $35 in liquidity because down here in my share balance, there's a 35. Now also on your $35, you're earning an 11.59% APR. Now 1.65% of that comes from USDC APR. Now what's also nice about staking in the USDC vault on Pika is that Pika is live with OP rewards. And so 9.94% of that APR is coming from OP. You'd be able to see your USDC rewards down here and your OP rewards down here as well. Now, one of the nice things about the Pika quest is that you can't actually unstake it until your 3 days is up, which means that they also allow you to claim your NFT right away. So we'll head over, we'll click get NFT. You should see the claim button pop up down here. We'll click claim. We'll sign the transaction. Okay, it looks like our transaction went through. We have our NFT. So we'll head over to Quix to check the price of our NFT. The link in the video description actually takes you directly to the Optimism Quest and has Pika selected for you. But if you're looking for it on your own or another one, you could type in Optimism Quest and then scroll down to category and you'll have all of your categories down here to select which NFT you want to look at. Looks like Pika is going for 0.0017 ETH right now. Okay, so now once our 3 days is up and we want to get our USDC back from the vault and claim our rewards, what we would do is we would go back to the vault and you would see you have USDC and OP rewards down here. You'll click the claim button and then you'll claim individually your USDC rewards and then you'll claim your OP rewards. And then you'll click unstake and then you can click this available withdrawal and you can click withdrawal, which we can't do that right now, but it tells you whenever you can withdraw, it looks like we'll be good on 11/5. You click the withdrawal and then you'll sign the transaction and you'll have your USDC back. And that's it. If you like the video, you can click the subscribe link above and it'll notify you each time I drop a new quest tutorial. I also linked the PQuest tutorial series playlist above if you want to check out any of the prior tutorials that I've completed. Thanks, guys.